So, Danielle, Dave tells me you're German.
Her name is Daniela, Mom.
That's what I said.
No, you said Danielle. Her name is Danielle, with an
Well, her American name is Danielle. And since we're in America, I choose to make her more comfortable.
Huh? Thank you, Mrs. Klublershturf.
Oh, you're very welcome, dear. She's very polite.
Who was that little boy earlier? The one with the tape measure?
It's my little brother, Ollie. He's retarded.
He's not retarded. He's a genius.
Whatever.
Ollie rarely comes down for supper, you know, being so busy and all. I mean, I don't think we've seen him since Tuesday.
What?
Tuesday.
Busy? Busy doing what? Being retarded?
No, he's building a time machine.
I think it is wonderful, Mrs. Klublershturf. You must be very proud of Ollie.
Oh, aren't you a sweetheart?
Here we go again.
Well, look who's here.
Good evening, Mother.
Good evening, dear.
Good evening, Poppy. Still alive, I see.
Who are you?
Ollie, this is Danielle. She is Dade's new German girlfriend.
We've met. Her name is actually Daniela. You're mispronouncing it, Mother.
I am?
That's what I've been saying for the past hour!
I do not think I have met you, Ollie.
You can drop the act.
I do not understand.
Poor Dade here probably thinks you actually like him. Little does he know he's but a pawn in your diabolical scheme.
What are you talking about, dork?
I'd explain it, but your lovely Dade is about 5 minutes away from killing our entire family. As always, your taste is impeccable.
He has a very active imagination.
Yes, he does.
Go ahead. Ask.
Ask what?
This is usually where you ask me about my time machine.
Very well, Ollie. I will play along. How is your time machine coming along?
As you already know, I have begun alpha testing. The results are very encouraging.
You gonna eat those potatoes, Ollie?
Help yourself, Father.
So you finished your time machine, Ollie. Can we see it?
I suppose.
It's an Atari joystick! Are you kidding me?
I had to disguise its appearance in order to confuse potential spies, but I guess the issue is moot now.
How does it work?
I suppose there's no harm in explaining. The device creates a rip in time-space, allowing me to travel to the point in history of my choosing. Of course, creating such a tear takes a massive amount of energy and results in a rather unpleasant noise. I call the effect the cosmic fart. You had better get the door, Mother.
The door? Oh, what a coincidence. I'll be right back.
For someone so concerned that their entire family is about to be killed, I find it, how do you say, odd. Yes, odd. That you would take this time to eat.
My dear, we have been through this chain of events 23 times now. While I have tried to vary the sequence leading up to the brutal murder of my loved ones, we always seem to end with the same result. My continued efforts to thwart your evil plans and create a paradox have significantly affected my appetite, so this time I'm eating.
Fascinating.
Isn't it, though?
You don't have to play along, Daniela. I wouldn't encourage him if I were you.
Ah, everybody, we have visitors. This is Chad and Barry, two nice boys who are selling Bibles door to door.
Hello, folks.
Sure is swell to make your acquaintance.
Seriously, Mother, Bible salesman? How could you fall for this time after time?
Please have a seat, and I'm gonna get two extra place settings.
Well, thank you, Mrs. Klublershturf.
Much obliged, ma'am.
Oh, how about that American football contest last evening? What an exciting match, huh?
I don't watch football.
Where are you fellas from?
Hollywood.
Oh, California boys, huh?
They're queers.
Here we go.
Thank you.
Wow. Those Bibles you boys sell must be very heavy. Ooh, look at those arms. Just like Conan.
Shucks.
We drink lots of milk, ma'am.
Can we cut to the chase, please?
Are you talking to me, sport?
Yes, you putrid Nazi swine. I am talking to you.
Oh, Ollie, that's not a nice way to treat our guests.
Ah, the bitter irony. The fate of the free world relies on my ability to convince my family that their dinner guests are in fact members of the Fourth Reich, poised to commandeer my time machine and use it for their own nefarious purposes.
Oh, little guy, I think someone's been watching too many cartoons.
Now, Daniela, she's good. No effort to hide the accent, patient, she set up a cover. Penetrated the family unit by romancing my inept brother. Barry and Chad, however, how anyone could believe they're actually Americans is beyond me.
Well, golly, I'm kind of insulted here.
Golly? Did you really just say golly?
How about gosh?
Ollie, if all this were true, why not alert the authorities? Surely no one is stopping you from using the telephone.
I tried to do just that the third time I traveled back to avert this catastrophe. As soon as I moved for the phone, you drew a gun and shot my mother. A very distressing incident, to say the least.
Oh, that's very sweet, Ollie.
But if I have a gun, as you say, why would I not just shoot you and take your silly machine?
Oh, you've tried that several times. Luckily, by the time you've drawn your weapon, I'm able to activate my machine and escape, only to do it all over again. I'm learning more and more each time, though, and I dare say I have prepared a series of unpleasant surprises for you Nazi bastards this go around.
Surprises?
3, 2...
Now, Ollie, that wasn't a very nice thing to do.
Sorry, Mother.
Here we go again. Those Bibles you boys sell must be very heavy. Ooh, look at those arms. Just like Conan.
Shucks.
We drink lots of milk, ma'am.
Oh.
This is certainly getting tedious. Daniela, we're going to have to work out some sort of compromise.
Excuse me?
Please, let's not play anymore. It always seems to end the same. I'm willing to concede that my family will offer no help. Although you're not aware of it, you should concede that you and your Gestapo pals will not be able to obtain my device. It would appear we have reached a stalemate.
Very well, Ollie. Let us hear your terms.
What are you talking about, Danielle? I already told you.
Silence! Oh. Anyway, as I was saying, we've reached a stalemate, and I must forfeit my device into your Aryan hands. I have only 3 conditions.
Of course.
First, you must spare the lives of me and my family. Except for Dade. I suppose you can kill him if you want to.
Done.
Wait a minute here! Oh.
Continue.
2, as you will obviously use the device to travel back to World War II and affect the outcome in Germany's favor, I ask that you influence Hitler to pick on someone other than the Jews. I ask this only out of obligation to my cultural identity. Perhaps the Mexicans would be a viable alternative?
There are Mexicans in Germany?
There are Mexicans everywhere.
You have my word.
My 3rd and final condition is that you show me your tits.
Excellent condition.
Thank you, Father.
Very well, Ollie. I shall reveal my breasts. I have your word that you will turn over the device.
Of course.
Now, the device, please.
I don't think so, you goose-stepping minx. As if I would ever surrender. Perhaps we shall go through this hundreds of times before I prevail. But I shall prevail.
That's my Ollie.
Maybe next time I'll get you to take off your pants, too.
Good for you, son.
Scheiße.
Cheerio.